and the tissue or the structure of the tissue. Connective tissue and supportive tissues are classified into two main groups with several subgroups, as we are. There are today connective tissue in general, Russian, I'm not about to go to the clinical. So we have connective tissue proper, connective tissue with special properties, and supporting connective tissue. Oh, okay, bring in an example of the connective tissue proper. I want to go to the hospital. Alanı birinde zor zor birinin bahsetti ama nitir ve sağlam nitir ve sağlam kıldı değil adamla doğru. So connective tissue proper is divided to the loose type and the dense type and dense is further subclassified to the regular and the irregular type. While the special property is the adipose tissue, elastic tissue, hemopoietic, but the empathic and the myoid and the mucous tissue. While the supporting connective tissue is divided to the cartilage and bone. Tabi ve sosyal robotun tıkanı is the bone, connective tissue, bu olay is, bone ve olay, part of the supporting connective tissue, so it is under the classification of connective tissue. Regarding the connective tissue proper that we will discuss today, it is of two types. The loose cellular connective tissue, so this connective tissue is very common and generally supports epithelial tissue. The loose connective tissue typically contains cells, fibers, and blasts, and some component of the passion and roughly equal parts and even a cell protein fiber and biomarker, T-grams, extensitia, and equal portions. The most numerous cells are the fibroblasts, but the other types of connective tissue cells are also present, along with nerves and blood vessels, so it is well vascularized. Other than empty shore, the feature capacity, it is very thin, very delicate, fashion. Both delicate, both it is not resistant, or not very strengthful, because it is has a large amount of ground substance. The ground substance tissue could also not be a tissue, it is a viscous, highly hydrated material. The proportionately, it's a piezo around connective tissue, it makes that tissue delicate, thin, and flexible. Collagen fibers predominate, but elastic and reticular fibers are also present, with a moderate amount of ground substance. Loose connective tissue has a delicate consistency, it is flexible and not very resistant to stress. Outside the erachi manushane, a cross-section through the loss of the other connective tissue, the erachi ebini. Ebini, the pinkish bundles of the collagen fibers running throughout the tissue regularly, mancha. You will see these thin hair-like black fibers, these are the elastic fibers. They are much thinner than the collagen fibers. There is also the reticular fibers, but we cannot see them in this HMP slide because they are not stained with silver. And you can see the different types of cells scattered among the ground substance between the fibers. And these white spaces, they are used to be filled with the ground substance which connects the cells to the fibers. It's like a messenger. It connects the cells and connects the nutrients. It delivers nutrients to the cells, messages, chemical mediators, and waste products. So it is very important. And on the other side, I also found that I'm very important. Really, it will be important in the human day, so it's for preparation. Regarding location of loose connective tissue, we found a new location that appears in the Russia. It falls the spaces of the body just deep to the skin, or the in the skin, beneath the epithelium of the skin, in the dermis. We found the loose connective tissue, just below the mesothelial lining of the internal body cavities, the cavity canine. It is associated with adventitia of blood vessels. Inshallah, next year we will study the histology of the blood vessels for the cardiovascular system. They are compared to adventitia. So adventitia is composed of loose cellular connective tissue. It surrounds the parenchyma of the glands. It is the part of the organs that is composed of the cell-specific to the organ. So it will surrounding, like a capsule. This is connective tissue of the mucous membrane, as in the elementary canal, is called the lamina propria. Hormone layer slightly coming from the skin. So this is the cross-section to the keratinized side of the skin. This is the keratin layer. This is the basal layers of the epidermis, of the skin. And this is the connective tissue, the endothelial epithelium. And each one is much darker, more intensely colored than the connective tissue. What is over asani, demarcation or the line that separates the epithelium from the underlying connective tissue, can be distinguished in the histological slide. So this is dark or purple in color, and the beneath it is the connective tissue, which is pinkish or gray in color. So this area is for the loose connective tissue, while deeper in the dense, we have the dense type of the connective tissue. What I recommend here, while I'm using the carotid, I create the shape of the indirectly. The dense connective tissue contains a greater abundance of fibers and fewer cells than the loose connective tissue. For the fiber, Mazora, cell mantle, don't start. Now, our target long substance mantle, some mantle, chip, and we have large amount of fibers, and these fibers are compact with each other. So the tissue will be more compact, so it is called dense. Gotcha? Thick edit. It contains most of the components found in the disconnected tissue, except that it has more fibers and fewer cells. How she can generalize it under here in 200? What is the histological difference between the loose cellular connective tissue and the dense one? Here, the orientation and the arrangement of the bundles of collagen fibers in this tissue makes it resistant to pressure. It is not flexible, it is rigid. Dense connective tissue is less flexible and far more resistant to stress than the loose connective tissue. So what are the subtypes of the dense? We have two types, the dense regular and the dense irregular connective tissue. In the irregular one, bundles of collagen fibers appear randomly interwoven. Fashion and entire fiber mantle, large bundles of collagen fibers that are running throughout the slide irregularly with different orientation. They are not running with each other, but parallel to each other in the same direction. The collagen fibers form a tough three-dimensional network, providing resistance to stress from all directions. It is often found closely associated with loose connective tissue or within the house epidermis, so for cytotic as microlegia, skin, loose epidermis, and wet beneath the epidermis. So our medema side, we have the dense type. Fine networks of elastic fibers are often scattered among the collagen bundles. Fibroblasts, the most abundant cells of this tissue, are located in the narrow spaces that separate between collagen bundles. Take example on these two slides. So on the left side, we have this histological slide stained with H&E. We can see the large, thick bundles of collagen fibers. For example, this one, this one, this one. Okay, so they are running in different orientations. Running not regularly. They are running irregularly, working out the irregular. And we have the nuclei of the fibroblast between them. So this is one nucleus, this is another nucleus, this is another nucleus. You can see the nuclei of the fibroblast cell running between irregularly or scattered between the randomly oriented to fibers, collagen fibers. Again, have the same slide, there's a regular connective tissue on side of here. You can see the fibroblast nuclei clearly, and these are the bundles running irregularly. So this is the dense irregular. Pneumonitis fire, as we said, dense of the skin, sheath of the nerves, capsules of the organs, and the tissue organ as a job loose shedding or as a job dense shedding, but mostly the dense irregular type that covers or embrace the organ. For example, on the spleen, the testis, ovary, kidney, and the lymph nodes. Again, the same slide here, where we can see the different layers of the epidermis, and this is. one in the deeper layer here is the dense cerebral connective tissue. And we have here in the walls of the blood vessels, again, dense cerebral connective tissue. Regarding the dense cerebral connective tissue fibers here, and along the way, they are arranged or oriented in a regular manner according to a different pattern with fibers and fibroblasts, aligned parallel for resistance to prolonged or repeated stresses exerted in the same direction. And in the heat cup, took a direction and different, so it will protect from stress from all directions. The very collagen fiber is oriented in different directions. While on this side, it is found in location or in areas in which the stress or the pressure is directed in one direction or in one alignment. For example, in the tendons, in the ligaments, and in the appendices. So here, there is a little wall of the knee, collagen mantle here. These are the collagen mantles on the paper layer. You can distinguish spaces between them. There are spaces, but with very little ground substance. Then, the side of the awati, with little ground substance, with very little spaces, wide spaces in the side between the fibers, especially the collagen fibers, and you know that it is of the dense type. To get a new cell, space a mantua, glass and stance mantua, cell mantua, space mantua, or empty space mantua, cell mantua, glass and stance mantua, fiber mantua, and the fibers are thick, and it's a way they are running irregularly or running regularly in terms. In the area of the mantua, we have, in the tendon, for example, the fibers running regularly. And in between, we have the regular, running parallel in between here. So we can see the nuclei, this space of the nuclei, left and space of the nuclei of the fibroblast running in between the bubbles. Very well, elastic fibrillation. Elastic fibrillation, it depends on the shiwazi preparation side of the side of the island. We can see the collective elastic fibers again running parallel with the rest of the bubbles. So now we go to sheep in some of which are modulated like fibers. So they are running power of each other. And I share the table like that. And then here, you don't have to memorize it. It's what you can put in the numbers for your location in your hands. And you have to use the dense regular and the dense regular. Actually, for the human members, the end of the day, it's a kind of similar. Regarding the particular connective tissue, this is a special type of connective tissue, meaning one of the particular fibers. And you can see the section as a particular fiber during the proportion of this one. So the fibers of type 3 collagen, okay, the particular fiber, protein T is the protein collagen of type 3. They form a dedicated 3D network that support various types of cells. The fibers networks of this specialized connective tissue is produced by modified fibroblasts and both tubular cell, motion mass tubular muscle tissue. So it remains associated with partially covering the fibers. The fibers provide a framework. Framework can be tied in to show up, you know, to shape is stable, the cell can only damage the structure of the analysis. That supports it. It's a meshwork or a matrix that supports itself. Where the energy and for the organic agent, for example, in the bone marrow, lymph nodes, and the spleen. Besides, because that macrophages and other cells of the monomer phagocyte system are also observed within this particular tissue, to monitor cells on their or passing through and to remove the disease. And other things are similar or dynamical related to the immune defense mechanism. Here are two schematic diagrams in the knee. These are the reticular cells that are sponsored for your actual fibroblast. Nothing with that else than the fibroblast. But I'm not here, although I have a reticular cell. So these are the spindle shaped fibroblast, which is called reticular cell. Reticular cell. And these are these fine network like fibers. These are the blood fibers of the reticular. Here we have a slide armor, so these are the network or the meshwork of the tumor. large number of lymphocytes. Common cells in the reticular cell that form the reticular fibers. What about the adipose tissue? Protein fibers and it was causing swelling of salivary glands. which is called edema. This is one clinical question. The causes of this edema is numerous. We have many causes. Later on, in we will study again. Regarding the second medical application is the keloids. How did my new keloids take keloids? And what are they? Cerebrinalgia, Schwinn's cave, Schwinn's cave, later on, it will be false, and become scar-like, but I hope that from Schwinn's connective tissue, Lasha, is the function of the cells of the connective tissue to fold the wound, Lasha, and form a scar. But in some conditions, in some races, this scar will be hypertrophied or causing a lot of swelling, like in this case. So the cure is a lot of swelling caused by abnormal large amounts of collagen fiber that forms in scars of the skin. Keloids occur most often in individuals of affected skin. They are a racing affected gladiator and can be a troublesome clinical problem to manage. Not only can they be disfigured and machine, but excision is almost always called by cuts. Unless Carpina she will get a lot of school video, go ahead and it is very unpleasant. What we call it, they have surgery, the plastic surgery, jointly fractured again. So this condition is not cured. The problem is in the process of the proliferation of the collagen fiber during the healing.